Over the years, Christians have flocked the Namugongo Martyr Shrine to pay pilgrimage to the Uganda Martyrs. The biggest event is on the 3rd of June, which was declared Martyrs' Day and ended yesterday. According to Father Simon Odhiambo Lambo, the acting parish priest of Mbiko, Kenyans started heading to Namugongo in 1993. The first Kenyan pilgrim was Josephat Cheprui. On May 31, 1998, on his way to the Martyr Shrine in Namugongo, Kenyan pilgrim John Kibe was knocked dead by a motor vehicle at Buola Stage in Mabira Forest, Buikwe District. In 2003, Buola was gazetted as a memorial and holy site in remembrance of the late pilgrim John Kibe. Since then, every year, as Kenyans make their way to Namugongo, they stop at this very spot to pray and honor John Kibe and are joined by the locals.
John Kibe was a pilgrim from Kenya, Nakuru Diocese, who in 1998, on his pilgrimage, died in a road accident, was knocked at Mabira Forest.
Father Simon Odhiambo tells that pilgrims continue to Namugongo after Kibe was killed. When they return to Kenya, they ask their then bishop, Peter Kairu, to help find a way to honor Kibe. In 2003, Buola was gazetted as a memorial and holy site.
Significant because this is a pilgrim that was coming from the Diocese of Nakuru, and the process of requesting that this place, a memorial site, should be created was actually an initiative by fellow pilgrims whom, after going back to Kenya, went to the Bishop of Nakuru. The then Bishop was Right Reverend Peter Kairu, who wrote to the Bishop of Lugazi Diocese, the then Matthias Sekamanya, and asking if it is possible for the government to gazette a place for a site in within Mabira Forest, especially where he was killed by the vehicle, so that every year they can meet there. Those pilgrims coming from Kenya and eastern Uganda can converge there in memory of John Kibe before proceeding to Namugongo.
Since 2003, pilgrims from Kenya and eastern Uganda have convened for prayers every 31st of May on their way to Namugongo. Father Odhiambo explained that Kibe's body was taken back to Kenya and the Catholic Church constructed an altar and two graves as a monument for Kibe because he died in faith. Father Odhiambo says the death of Kibe has inspired many pilgrims, mostly from Kenya and eastern Uganda.
Actually, what we're seeing there is the altar, because the first thing to remember the place after it has been given to the church, that it's now a site, memorial site for Kibe, two crosses were erected there as a memory. And then with the time, an altar where it's not buried there per se, but the memorial site, the monument, is there.
So, Kibe was buried where? Was he taken back to Kenya?
Yes, he was taken back home.
Okay, so this is just a memorial site.
Memorial site where he died.
While delivering his sermon at the memorial site this week, Father Patrick Ochen of Gangama Parish in Tororo Diocese asked the pilgrims to give to the needy, respect people, and also pray constantly.
Speaking to the needs of the saints, we must transmit this love, this faith to others. St. Paul also reminds us, my brothers and sisters, that all of you in respect to one another.
Over 2,500 pilgrims attended the prayers, and Father Stephen Odhiambo asked them to pray for peace and for the economy to stabilize.
King, for having protected us throughout the lockdown, that difficult moment, we can only say, but thank you to God.
Report by Emmanuel Balukusa for the news.